I am Dr. Suvarna Joshi, working as Associate Professor in Department of Microbiology in BJ Government Medical College, Pune. I am working as an in-charge of COVID laboratory in the Sassoon Hospital. We will be discussing today how do we do the diagnosis of COVID-19 in laboratory by using various tests. In the first session, we will see what are the samples we can collect and how do we transport it for further testing. For that, one should know like to whom we should be tested. So any individual presenting with fever, without or with cough, having headache or sore throat, breathlessness, headache, body ache, and recent loss of smell, fatigue or diarrhea should be considered as a suspect case of COVID-19 unless proven otherwise by confirmation of other etiology. So these are the variety of manifestations which is being presented by the COVID-19 patient. So when any of these symptoms are there, one should suspect COVID-19 and collect the swab. So basically we collect two different swab, nasopharyngeal swab and oropharyngeal swab. So these swabs are being shown in the slide. One is thin and one is thick. The thin one is used for nasopharyngeal swab and the thick one is used for collection from the throat, that is oropharyngeal swab. Once the swab is taken, it is being put in a viral transport medium which is shown in a test tube, which is a screw cap tube having a liquid medium. So with this, the virus remains alive and this tube is being transported at 4 degree temperature. So when you are transporting this sample to the lab, one has to take care that it should not be spilled. So it is being put it in a Ziploc plastic bag and then transported in a either thermocol box which has your gel pack, or you can transport it at 4 degree with the ice pack. In the next session, we'll see how do we do the antigen test for after the swab collection. For the antigen collection, usually we collect the nasopharyngeal swab. Once the swab is taken, we do the test. Remember, like any other infection, we do not do antigen test on the blood sample. And it is an immunochromatographic test. But if you want to do the RT-PCR test in case of those who come negative by a rapid antigen test, a separate swab is required. The swab which is used for antigen testing cannot be used for RT-PCR test. So you will need a separate swab for RT-PCR test. What are the advantages of antigen test? The first and most important is that it is rapid method, it is cheaper, and it requires just 15 to 30 minutes. No sophisticated instrument is required, no skill is required, and it can be done at bedside or in a mobile van or in a mobile lab. It can be done in an easy way. So once the swab is collected, it is being taken into the lysis buffer which is provided into the antigen kit. Once you put that swab into the antigen kit, it is just swirled for 4 to 5 times and then the nozzle is put on that tube and you just have to add the drops. 3 to 4 drops are added on the cartridge. Once you add that drops of lysis buffer, then you can see either a single line, color line which is developed, or 2 lines. If 2 lines are developed, that means test is positive. If single line is developed, that means test is negative. If no line is developed, that means test is invalid. Okay, so it is just a 15 minutes procedure. 1 minute required hardly for collection of sample, putting it into the lysis buffer, swirl the swab for 4 to 5 minutes, put a nozzle on the tube, put it 4 to 5 drops on the cassette and just wait for the color development. That simple is the test. Now you have to follow the ICMR guidelines that once the rapid antigen test comes positive, that indicates there is a high viral load. then only the rapid antigen test comes positive. That is why the ICMR's guidelines are that once the test person tested positive by rapid antigen test, that is RAT, no need to do RT-PCR test. So symptomatic individuals who are identified positive by RAT should not be retested, and he is just advised to go for home isolation, or if the symptoms are there, then he may be advised hospitalization as per the ICMR guidelines. Furthermore, the ICMR has developed guidelines that no testing is required for COVID-19 for the hospital discharge. If the person is admitted and you have to decide whether to discharge the patient after the disappearance of the clinical manifestation, one has to remember, now the guidelines has changed, that you have to monitor for last 3 days. Like if the 7 days patient is admitted, so for last 3 days, that is 8, 9 and 10, patient is having no symptoms, then he can be discharged without retesting by either of the tests. So no need to do rapid antigen test and RT-PCR test for discharge purpose. The discharge has to be given on the basis of clinical development or clinical progress of the patient. The symptomatic individuals who are identified negative by rapid antigen test, symptoms are present but rapid antigen test came negative, then there is a possibility that person is having low viral count or low viral load, and to confirm that he is true negative, in that situation only we recommend, or ICMR guidelines says, that RT-PCR test should be done. So in such cases, those who are symptomatic and rapid antigen test came negative, in those individuals the second swab should be collected and send it for RT-PCR test. Now the recently on 4th of May 2021, ICMR has changed the guidelines for travelers. So you have to remember that now there is no need to do RT-PCR test for healthy individuals who is undertaking the interstate domestic travel. It has been completely removed to reduce the load of RT-PCR testing on the laboratory. It is not necessary. Non-essential travel and interstate travel of symptomatic individuals who may have just flu-like symptoms should be essentially avoided. That means if you have any symptoms suggestive of flu or COVID, it's better not to travel, rather than testing and finding negative and then I will travel and next day you may come positive. So it is not a foolproof that today if you are coming, your test is negative, whether it's a RT-PCR test or rapid antigen test, that means you are negative for that particular day. You may come positive maybe after 24 hours, maybe after 48 hours. So that's the reason why it has been removed for the traveler.